Hello and welcome to another Sonic Without Defeating a Badnik. For anyone asking for Mania, I'm still on it, it's just taking a little bit longer than I expected it to. For now, we're coming back to Sonic 3 and Knuckles so we can find out whether or not I can complete this challenge as Knuckles. Believe it or not, but I didn't beat this game as Knuckles until I started this channel. True story. It was brutal because Knuckles' playthrough is basically hard mode. His lower jumps couldn't make or break the run for me, so why not give it a shot? The rules are the same as before. During the playthrough, I cannot defeat a single Badnik, which are enemies that take one hit to defeat. In Sonic 3 and Knuckles, they also give points and release the animal inside. If I defeat one, I must restart the level. I still need to make progress, so bosses and mini-bosses must be defeated. The run ends when I either get to the credits, or if I give up. I still remember the struggles and discoveries made in the original run, so I hope things will go a bit smoother the second time around. Let's answer the all-important question, can you beat Sonic 3 and Knuckles without defeating a Badnik as Knuckles? Let's find... Oh, right. I was going to use the PC version of Sonic 3 and Knuckles, but I was having far too many issues with capturing it, so I'll be playing the Sega Genesis version once again, but I'll be subjecting you to the PC music. Enjoy! Angel Island Zone Act 1 starts with me running from this Rhinobot. Why are they this fast? So I drop down, grab Emerald number 1. From there, it's smooth sailing, running as I go through the loop, go underneath the monkey dude, and run up the tree to watch the island catch fire. After I gain control again, I drop down to grab Emerald number 2. Past the springs, I get to the Caterkiller Jr., and thankfully, its path is pretty far, otherwise I'd have to take another route. Speaking of, this is where we come across our first diversion from the original, breaking these rocks to bring us to the Fire Breath. It doesn't take too much to destroy it. Act 2 is going to be different at the start. It's a spike-infested cave section that isn't too tough with the Caterkiller Jr., but the Rhinobot is going to be trouble. The spike coming out of the top means that I can't easily get past it. Damage boosting would work, but I fell off the platform. And gliding over it didn't work. Normally I'd start over, but since I didn't really go through a checkpoint, I just took a death. Second time around, oh, it's not as bad. Back to the Rhinobot, I had to catch it on the edge to jump over it. I climbed out of the cave and ran through the loops. From there, I jumped over the two Bluminators and hated these pointless springs. Now I'm at the... Oh, that's an Egg Robo. This time the Egg Robo takes control of the Flame Mobile. It has a slightly different attack pattern and it's gone. The zone ends with Knuckles jumping into Hydrosity. That's pretty badass. Act 1, top route. I should say I eventually take the top route, starting with the hidden spring. The bubble shield would have been nice, but the Blastoid had other plans for me. I break the beginning of this bridge to grab Emerald number 3. There was a nice little bit to just run past all the Point Dexters. Then, reality hits. I'm at this section again. For those who don't remember, it took so many tries to get rid of the Turbo Spiker. Attempt number 1, I drown. It's a good start so far. Attempt number 2, and I jump into a Point Dexter, then I avoid the Turbo Spiker to finally destroy another Point Dexter not defending itself. Attempt number... Why didn't I just climb? No, seriously, I'm making this much harder than it needs to be. From there, these Turbo Spikers demand my lunch money, and I make it to the end. I should really climb more. It actually helps cheese the Big Shaker, after it shakes me down for my remaining pocket change. Act 2 is a bop. When I get to the Jaws, I chose to let them spawn one at a time. I'm making it a point to avoid rolling, but these slides will force me to do it, so I don't want to fall back in the water once I'm launched out of it. Now to get rid of this Turbo Spiker. I forget how many times this loop and slide setup is repeated. Thankfully, It's fine, I just took some damage. Getting flung out of the water again puts me in the right place for Emerald number 4. Now, I spend a ridiculous amount of time trying to get sent to the highest part. I eventually gave up after I managed to do that. So it's a climb until I somehow manage to land on the side of the spike and take damage? I feel like that shouldn't happen. So this is the area that I have nightmares of. The Jaws destroys itself, and I'm left to do another climb, but took a detour to Emerald number 5. At this point, I'm at where Sonic's route usually goes to the boss, but sadly, I can't drop down. So, I have another route to take. It basically means I'm gliding over two spike pits, not so successfully, and dropping down to fight against the Screw Mobile. It goes down, and we move on. Marble Garden Act 1 starts with the slopes taking me all the way to the bottom where I meet up with the Tunnel Bot. It didn't want to play. A little climbing and a little platforming leads me to this. To avoid getting turned into Swiss cheese, I hopped off the side spikes, then I found this hole in the wall for Emerald number 6. There's not a whole lot left to deal with. After grabbing the fire shield, the spikers won't do much, and I wait for the bubbles to get out of the way so I can fight the Tunnel Bot. At least I got to keep the shield. Act 2 starts, and I touch the pokey. Honestly, I had no idea what I was trying to accomplish with that. From there, I ran underneath the mantis. The same couldn't be said about this spiky accident. Poked through a hole in the wall and spun around these monitors. Really? Fine, take two. Grabbed the monitors, then rode the spinning top. I did make the mistake of going away from this broken floor, so it respawned. After the mantis, I ran to avoid getting crushed and grabbed the last Chaos Emerald. Because in this challenge, nothing will go wrong from doing this. I go on the next spinning top and oh crap, somebody stop! This. Okay then. Running around these loops, I chose to jump off the right side and then took damage to control the distance of my spin dash. They'll buy that, right? I did get a dead end at this phase, which is actually called a relief. And it's a relief that I don't have to fight it because I have to find another way around. I feel like I jumped at random after hitting the spring, but it does give me a new route to take. Oh great, the level's falling. It does get a little nerve-wracking here because there's always the chance of getting crushed or hitting something, but there's no real badniks here. So that's a relief. From here, it's the Drill Mobile, and we're done with Marble Garden. Thank goodness! Carnival Night starts and... damn, that was fun. From there, the BatBots try to bully me for trying to have fun. Then they get in the way of my fun. Take two, and I miss the platform I need to keep going. These cannons aren't helping. I got a bit further, but I didn't think to avoid using the barrel. I swear I've played this game before. It was a tactical enemy despawn. Trademark. Damn these sparkles that I totally called Blastoids in the original video. Blame the manual, not me. After gliding over the spike pick, no, not the barrel again! So at this bit, there is a BatBot coming to me. Climbing the wall didn't work, and I need to distract it. Thank you, conveniently placed Big Ring. After a damage boost, I make it to the bowling spin. I think I made a huge mistake. I don't even think I can air this death. I mean, the death allowed for the tactical enemy despawn, trademark, but I have no rings now. After a little camera manipulation, it's done. Act 2 is pretty neat to start. Go fast and take the Knuckles route. It's pretty manageable until the BatBot comes to ruin my day. This time, I didn't fall into spikes, so I can make it over and avoid the sparkles. A whole lot of nothing happens. No, seriously, a whole lot of nothing happens. I thought turning super would screw me over, but nope, the level is over. I'll take it. After teleporting into Ice Cap Zone, it looks a little empty. I mean, there's the star pointer, but there's not much else for a while. Then, penguins. I mean, penguinators. After that, it's more smooth sailing until the level decides to prove a point. Then I finally got to have some fun, until I ran face first into a penguinator. But after that, it's pretty uneventful, even with the march of the penguinators. At this point, I wish I had more rings so that way I can go super, because now I'm fighting the big Istus. With Act 2, it's not bad because there are some loops to have a bunch of fun. Then this little chunk gave me a few close calls with the penguinators. I could really do without being frozen. Damn it. There's another segment with the floating platforms and penguinators, which is a bit easier. And from there, I broke out to the great outdoors. Sorry folks, no grass to touch. At the end, I wanted to go into the fight with Super Knuckles at least once, so I did know of a Big Ring location. This made the Freezer Mobile fight so one-sided, but I wanted this. Starting in Launch Base, I didn't alert the Flybot 767 this time. It's possible to get past the Orbonaut and two Corkies without getting hurt, but this isn't one of those attempts. Same for the Ribbot, but I was punched for mistiming it. There was a point where I was trying to avoid damage from another Ribbot, but I didn't think to jump after the spin dash, so I lost progress. To avoid getting roasted, I turned super. And you know what? It was going as well as it could have. Next time around, I chose to glide on these slopes because it's actually a lot more effective. So if you see a piece of land sticking out in this game, don't stand on it. That happened and I alerted the Flybot 767. Thank goodness it didn't want to bother with me. At this spot with the Ribbot, Snail Blaster, and the Corki, I took the tube somewhere else. It takes me near the end, but I jumped into the bonus stage so I can get more rings because I just wanted a one-sided fight against the Twin Hammer. And Act 1 is finished. Act 2, and I'm damage boosting like a mad lad. First the Ribbot, then the Orbonaut. Then there was one that is necessary, and it's at this other Ribbot. Trying to walk under it didn't work because it's a bit lower, but nope, a self-inflicted wound is the preferred method. There is a small bit where you can run over two Ribbots, which actually looked pretty cool, but the Orbonaut spoils the fun 1 second later. A ton of fumbling around, and I really mean a ton of it. I then raised a water level and pushed myself into this wall somehow. I feel like that's the second time it's happened. Thanks to the nearby bubble shield, I can use my damage invincibility to go on spikes. And I would say I got to keep the rings, but nope. Ribbot. And now we're at the beam rocket. that electric orb makes it much tougher than it needs to be. Three more attempts later, and it's time to fight the big arm, which only needed one attempt. That taken care of, we're done with the Sonic 3 portion of the game. Mushroom Hill Zone Act 1. I duck underneath the butter droids to get into the big ring. Bye, super transformation. I'll take a super armor, dude. Grabbed a flame shield only to lose it to a mush meanie, and around this point I wanted to climb up for reasons, but I will say going up had to be the smartest idea because there's next to no badniks. I mean, I did see a dragonfly, but not much else, and eventually I got to the Hey-Ho. That's a rude name. To finish Act 1. Act 2. Oh boy. I started with 10 rings, which is really neat, but from there, I break the wall with my face to get to this Cluckoid. If you recall, Knuckles has a short jump. Not only that, but I can get on the edge and try to spin dash because it is on the edge. It didn't work. The next plan was to try getting to a higher spot in the level, but there's no way I can climb up to that wall up there, since nothing else can get me that high up. And with that, I feel like I'm out of options. There's no way I can get around this. So, it looks like this is the end of you have to jump on the very edge of the platform and glide over it. I wish I was joking about that. I really wish I was. I thought the glide would force me to land directly on it, but nope, it lets me go over it. Now I have to keep playing. I hope I don't mess it up. There's nothing until I get to this next Cluckoid, and damn it, I'm stuck! Okay, good to go. I wanted nothing to do with this mush meanie in the cramped spot. Same for this Cluckoid, which is basically a dead end. So I spin dash jump to get to another big ring. Two super emeralds down. Spring shenanigans ensue, and it's a shame I can't knock out this Cluckoid because there's a big ring behind it. But now I'm at the Jet Mobile. It took two attempts, but we're done. Flying Duracell Zone. Flying Battery Zone. I grabbed a flame shield while avoiding these blasters and techno squeaks. Here I chose to play it safe and glide over this capsule. After carefully going under these spikes and blasters, I'm at this fork in the road which I chose to go up. From there, there isn't a damn thing until the end, and I wish I was making that up. In fact, here, take a look at my footage. Now that the capsule is continuously hitting itself, Act 1 is over. Act 2 starts with avoiding these techno squeaks and going down. Not a whole lot happens until I get to this big magnet. I had to get rid of the lightning shield so I can get around the blasters, which is not a problem because there's a fire shield right here. Also a near death. I was then sprung up to this magnet, and I wanted to get even higher because there's a few big ring locations that I was trying to remember. One fun speed segment later, and I have to slow down. Thanks, invincibility box. Even the blasters started bullying me for making that mistake. Then did it again. From there, it's some timed platforming and the surprise techno squeak. After that is... ugh, fine, I'll damage boost. Oh, and Super Emerald 3. Also, I missed the other big rings that I was trying to go for. But now it's boss time. The Barrier Eggman, or should I say Barrier Egg Robo, is a breeze, and so is the Hang Mobile. I think I had an easier time here than the original run. Can I be honest with you? I hate sand. It's coarse and on course for being one of the most boring themes for a Sonic zone. Starting off with Sandopolis Zone, I was trying to go up as high as I can to see where exactly I can go. It was going well until spikes. Aside from that, it was working. Sure, there were some scorps, but they were so out of reach and the Rockins can't really be defeated by jumping on top of them. I then wanted to go down the sandfall, but the sandworm wanted a big hug and the scorp wanted a high five. I didn't appreciate either of those. With this Rockin in the way, I had to backtrack a little to go down another path to nearly get crushed. These Rockins are out for blood. Things are going well until this scorp got in the way. As I get back, rather than trying to go down the same route, I go to the highest route possible. In fact, it's here on this map. And from there, it's pretty empty until the Guardian boss fight. Act 2 starts with death. Wait, why is there no light in this pyramid? At the start, there's a long stretch of nothing, followed by an already destroyed capsule. I love the reminder that this takes place after Sonic's story. I just didn't appreciate how I was reminded of it. I then climb up because I refused to ride the sand the right way, and then I said screw it, I'll do it properly. And then missed the jump to... what the hell? How did that happen? Also, the first actual badnik in 3 minutes. And it's a scorp that I have to damage boost through. In fact, there are a few that make platforming, or grabbing item monitors, a bit annoying. Remember that cork that releases the sand? My plan was to never hit it, to avoid getting crushed. And honestly, I'll never understand how that actually worked. And then I had to damage boost. Then I had to do it again. Unfortunately, I died in the sandfall because I wanted to avoid redoing this entire act. Thanks to the sandworms. a little bit further, and it's another big ring, which makes 4 Super Emeralds. And this area is an experience. The idea is to release the sand, push the block to the larger switch. Hey, the source I'm using is calling it a switch, so I'm going with it. Doing that will open the path forward. Only problem, this scorp. Dying will cause me to lose a significant amount of progress, which happened. The only way through is to damage boost and grab the nearest ring. It'll take time, but it's the only way. If only I had more than a minute remaining for the egg golem. But after a timeout, I took a minute to beat the egg golem. Whatever, it's done. I hate the zone. After falling into lava reef, I am crushed. After that, the tunnel bot makes a hole next to it. Even though there are fireworms and toximisters, getting crushed has been my biggest enemy. Same for the fireball. Then the spike ball. Okay, every non-badnik hazard has been my enemy. Okay, you know what? Let's be serious about this. The toximister smoke is the only real thing in my way, except for the damn fireworms. I just can't catch a break. This zone isn't too tough, all things considered. Really, it's the fireworms being the biggest obstacle because they tend to show up where Knuckles would jump. And then it's the heat arms. You know what? I had some issues at the start, but it's a much easier level than I thought. Act 2, it's the bottom route for me. After hopping over some spikes, I was sprung into a bonus stage. Sadly, the fun that I was having with this fire shield came to an end thanks to this fireworm. Then there's a massive section with lots of waiting for the fire to go away, or the spikes to move, or the Iwamadoki to do its best. You got it. And then we get this awesome segment to glide. Hey, look, it's the background. Looks nice. Wow. Lava Reef is such an uneventful zone, when you don't count mistakes. Now for Hidden Palace. Now for Sky Sanctuary. We get Crane Ganged to the coolest iteration of any metallic Sonic character, Mecha Sonic. After bopping his head a couple times, it's time for him to power up. Using the Master Emerald, Mecha Sonic becomes Super Mecha Sonic. Although this is the coolest thing to witness, he's pretty easy. A few bops when he powers down and the game is over. Knuckles flexes his strength by lifting the Master Emerald, and hey, there's Sonic flying his plane. So, can you beat Sonic 3 and Knuckles as Knuckles without defeating a badnik? The answer is yes. This was a very interesting playthrough, and this was also a very exhausting playthrough. It's one of the more difficult ones because of Knuckles' lower jump, the loss of a glide when I get all 7 emeralds, and the Cluckwood in Mushroom Hill, and on top of that, the eternity it took to get through Sandopolis 2. Lava Reef being one of the easiest ones if you take away player error is not something I was expecting, but once I saw the Toximisters, it was done. I am aware I didn't get the Super Emeralds, but it doesn't seem to affect the ending. It would have been nice to have, but I think I was better off without the Hyper Transformation. Oh, and Super Mario Bros. Z is totally the reason I love Mecha Sonic. Look up the fight he had against Axum Rangers X. He is such a badass. And that'll do it for this edition of Without Defeating a Badnik. I hope you enjoyed the PC soundtrack. Okay, in all seriousness, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm probably going to get back to chipping away at that Mania video, but I can't promise it as the next one. Just look out for my socials, my community tab posts, my Discord server, to find out which one is next. So that's going to do it for this episode of Sonic Without Defeating a Badnik. If you enjoyed it, give it a like. If you're new, subscribe to the channel. Click the bell icon to get notifications for new content. And at this time, I want to give a shout out to the members of Nux Club Plus. These are the channel members on YouTube and the patrons over on patreon.com/knucklescannel. Their names are on screen right now. Thank you all so much for your extra support, it is greatly appreciated. Especially to the Super Tier members, whose names are Dork in a Hat, Tactical Discord, Martin YT Plays, Ultrasonic Hero, Gamer Entertainment TV, and Francis Nam. Endgam? If you hear this part of the video, please tell me how I have to properly say your name. I just want to make sure I get it right. So if you want to join Nux Club Plus, again, you can do so with the join button below this video, but you can also use patreon.com/knucklescannel. And if you go with the $5 tier, you can also have your name mentioned at the end of these videos. You also get videos like these earlier than everyone else, but that's for everyone, both tiers. Thank you all so much for watching the video. I hope you all have a wonderful and safe day, and I will catch you for the next Without Defeating a Badnik. Until then, take care.